Yes. Yeah, I'm actually really nervous, so yeah. Just putting it there. Yeah. Okay, I'll tell you. So, as we've always learned, you know, we've been taught that practicing organic farming is the solution to the major concerns of the farming community. But majority of the community still practices the conventional style of it. Now, like, if the farmer is opting to practice the conventional style, you know, then that is definitely the most effective solution for him. Because koi bhi aise nahi aayega yaar isme zyada nuksan hai to main yahi karunga, hai na? To kuch to ganit hai jo hum nahi samajh rahe. Because he has grown up on his land. And he knows his land more than anybody else could know. So for me to find out was to, the only reason left for me to find this out was to carry out an experiment. And that is why I went to Vidarbha. To find out that how economical, how sustaining, and how feasible agriculture in general is, be it organic or conventional. Because, and for that, what we did was we formed a team of farmers where every farmer came ahead in voluntarily said that he would practice organic farming on one portion of his land in challenge to the conventional style that he's always been doing. You know? So in this process, did I learn that we're actually living with the last generation of farmers. You know? Because farming as an occupation is not economical, sustaining, or feasible. Like, everybody there who I was working with was of my father's age. Everybody my age had already migrated to the cities or trying really hard to make it there. The problem is not a migration, but the fact that they leave out of no option or an alternative. So it's not their choice to go. So in my initial days, the only question they had for me was why? Why had I, a college graduate from cities, come down here? It was so difficult for them to digest that why would I want to make a living here while they are just trying to survive? And given an option, they probably don't want to be farmers. Because, well, who would want to be a farmer? You know, let me tell you a story of Ajay. You know, he was a farmer in our community. You know, he last year he did exactly what a farmer would do, thinking that this year is going to be extremely fruitful. So with all that motivation, he started preparing his land. Then he sowed his seeds. And the very next day of sowing, like, it was heavy rainfalls that washed all the seeds out. So bearing additional cost, he thought, you can't really predict nature. He sowed them again. And in the process of 3 months, he took utmost care of his crops. He fed them, he checked if it needed any help, you know, in growing, if it was sick or it was doing just fine. And at the time of fruition, his crops faced a massive pest attack. And he did his best to solve the issue. But in no time, did the pest destroy the crop completely. 2 acres of produce, all gone. Along with the hard work he put, the time that he invested, and the money that followed, all gone. And all of this happened in front of my eyes. And what I could do was just stand there, helpless. And to top everything, he was going to have a second child that year. So I don't know, I didn't want to imagine how he was going to survive that year. So why would Ajay want to farm again? Or anybody for that matter? You know, there was this another person. You know, he was roughly my age. Like, he was 6 years elder to me. But he just didn't want to be a farmer. He tried, you know, his best to do odd jobs in the cities, which roughly paid him 6,000 a month, which bared the cost of eating, travel, maintenance of his farm and his entire family. So there was nothing that he could save up to. So the only option left for him was farming. But still, he just didn't want to get into it. And it's not only about him. I'm not sure who in this room also would be willing to work under 50 degrees of temperature, you know, in like adverse climatic situations, working your field out, doing hardcore labor, changing pipes, everything, and still be unsure of any kind of return. You know? So I figured that while solving an issue or approaching an issue, it is really important that we start acknowledging first what they want from us instead of what I want from them. And I learned that one day through Kiran. Now Kiran was a part of the community and the experiment that we're taking forward. So one day, you know, in the middle of the day, he called me, "Atta ne attas tu pesticide gheun ye, nahitar tumhi chemical taktu hai." Huh? Matlab, the pesticide was the organic pesticide that we had prepared for the experiment. Aur wo puri dhamki de raha tha. So which got me thinking, yaar, what, who is he farming for? No, I was like, it felt like he was doing all of this for me and not himself. You know, I was there working hard, trying to give all that I can in helping him, but turns out that he's doing me a favor. So, and after some time I thought that, yeah man, he's right. He's right, because for him, it was a question of survival. And we were at complete loggerheads in solving one problem. Though the problem was the same, and it was effective and going to be effective gradually, but the actions that, the solutions that we put to action were extremely irrelevant to the problems he was facing. Like, I cannot be there standing, talking to him about the health of his soil, sand, seed, you know, the environment, everything, when he's struggling with the thought of how is he going to feed his family tonight. You know? And that's when I realized that I didn't go to Vidarbha with my problem. I went there with a prescribed solution. And it is only then, when, that I identify my problem, will I gradually be able to solve the bigger problem, you know? So the first was to understand what he wanted from me. And the problem, and I only think that it is only possible that when you find that dot, the problem, you know, will you be able to gradually, your strategies will start forming and eventually reaching to the bigger goal in building sustainable communities. Because there are a lot of problems. And for me, and it could be anything, you know, like, see, for example, seed. If your problem is seed, so your plan of actions will revolve around those, that solving of the problem of seeds and monocultures and gradually getting to the bigger goal, or say water or land or whatever it is, or market, anything. So my problem and solution started in developing an economical structure. You know, so how do I build that? That's what came to me next. So now, you know, it's really interesting how a farmer who owns every bit of his land, hence owns every bit of the produce on his land, and the produce being that the world is dependent on. So technically, he should be the game changer or at the top of power dynamics, right? But turns out that he isn't. He's actually trying hard, struggling rather, to survive in the setup. Now, how does that happen? You know, it was so strange and thrilling for me that it got me involved. Oh, why is it so? How am I going to be a part of it? And what is it that I am going to do collectively to solve it? And that's how production. Okay, let me, like, yeah, I forgot. Now, so the power dynamics has three people in the ratio: the producer, the agency, the government or the agency, or the consumer. The producer, who wants the cost of his, the selling cost of his produce to be at ever, like, rising. Okay, he wants it to be the maximum that it can. Okay, the consumer will want the cost of his produce to be at all-time low. Okay, now food as an entity is required, it's a necessary for the richest of rich to the poorest of poor. You know, so the government or the agency will try and limit the cost, you know, ke ye sabko mile, samanta mein, universal. Hai na? But at the same time, kisan ne koi theka leke to nahi baitha na, ki yaar, log bhuke hai to main khana khilaunga. Uske liye to ye dhanda utna. It's his business for him. So even when the limit is that much and his cost of production is that much, why will he want to conduct such a business which is creating such a loss for him? You know, that it has reached the edge of survival, being the last generation of farmers. So in my understanding, कि अगर ये तीन लोग ही है रेशियो में और इन तीनों के पास कोई पावर नहीं है टू गवर्न हाउ थिंग्स विल फ्लो, कंज्यूमर डजेंट हैव इट, द एजेंसी डजेंट हैव इट और द गवर्नमेंट डजेंट हैव इट एंड डेफिनेटली द प्रोड्यूसर डजेंट हैव इट, तो हु इज एट द टॉप ऑफ पावर डायनामिक्स, हु इज कंट्रोलिंग एंड गवर्निंग ऑल ऑफ दिस? इट्स एक्चुअली अ पर्टिक्युलर फोर्स, यू नो, विच इज लीडिंग अस समवेयर, एंड दैट फोर्स is what most of the people call it, the market. So I started to understand that, okay, if I get to know the patterns, if I know how the market functions and the patterns of its growth, and then the producer can start gaining power. Right? So that's how production by the masses comes into place. That's the solution. Right? So this production by the masses, this mass production and production by the masses. Now production by the masses is when everybody, you know, in the section comes ahead in contributing and creating a structure. Okay, a simple logic hai ki agar gaon khali ho rahe hain aur shahar bhar rahe hain aur shahar wo jagah hai jahan supposedly economy boom ho rahi hai, to fir मेरे हिसाब से तो लोग इकोनॉमी बना रहे हैं, है ना? तो अगर रूरल डेवलपमेंट या रूरल इकोनॉमिकल डेवलपमेंट करना है तो हमें सिंपल करना है कि लोगों को वापस लेके आना है, है ना? एंड हम लोग लोगों को वापस कैसे लेके आएंगे? व्हेन वी स्टार्ट क्रिएटिंग दोज अपॉर्चुनिटीज. और वो अपॉर्चुनिटी हम लोग जैसे बात कर रहे थे कि वैसे भी लोग विदाउट एन ऑप्शन जा रहे हैं, है ना? तो वो अपॉर्चुनिटीज अपने हिसाब से कैसे शेप लेंगे कि वो जो वो वहाँ क्या देखने जा रहे हैं कि वो यार शायद वो लाइफस्टाइल बेटर है, वो हमें यहाँ कैसे बना सके, है ना? सो इट्स सो प्रोडक्शन बाय द मासेस इज एक्चुअली अ स्ट्रक्चर, यू नो, वेयर दीज पीपल गेट टुगेदर टू बिल्ड देयर इकोनॉमी. नाउ से आई विल जस्ट गिव यू एन एग्जांपल, हाउ बनानास, ओके, बनानास इज लाइक 40 rupees अ डजन इन द सिटीज, बट द कॉस्ट ऑफ बनाना चिप्स इज 300 rupees अ किलो. So you see the margin here now, you know, or say the cost of cotton and the whole process of getting it to the cloth, you know, leading it where we wear clothes today. Like, so the whole process can be integrated, it can be labor intensified, you know, and bought to us, you know, where every person gets his power in creating his economy. है ना, रादर जो मास प्रोडक्शन में जहाँ एक ही जन मुनाफा खा रहा है, यहाँ लोग की सत्ता बन रही है ना? सो दैट्स हाउ वी स्टार्टेड बिल्डिंग प्रोडक्शन बाय द मासेस, यू नो, इन क्रिएटिंग दोज अपॉर्चुनिटीज, इन क्रिएटिंग अ प्रॉब्लम ऑफ इकोनॉमिकल स्टेबिलिटी इन द रूरल सेक्टर. Now, when I'm saying that, you know, that you have to prioritize your problem, you have to identify, you know, and then define your role in it, and then accordingly create those action plans. At the same time, you cannot be like a horse with blinkers on, you know, because this structure is so dynamic. You know, it's like a space. It's like the space. It's like the outer space, you know, that it functions at various levels, you know, and that you might not even know. So while forming our team, you know, what happened was, now all the members in our team happened to be, you know, as they say, of the upper caste. Now for me, I am from a city and I've never been affected because probably I'm from, I don't know, I was never been affected, so it never crossed my mind that something like that is deep rooted or, you know, I just neglected it, basically. So how, you know, these upper caste people, you know, like were in my team, because like they were just people for me and farmers and we were trying to get to a solution, you know, but when we wanted to reach, make our reach, like grow our reach and expand our whole idea, at that time, like the so-called lower caste thought that I was an agent of the upper caste. So it started to deflate my structure in its foundation levels itself, you know. So even though when I'm saying my problem is, yaar, mereko paisa hi banana, ye karna, wo karna, matlab logo ke liye, to ye caste, waste, region, ye sab mere liye nahi hai. But at the same time, it is extremely important that you know what's happening besides you, with you. Because even when it is not your problem, it is going to affect a structure. And when you enter another ecosystem, even though we are in one, it is really important to start acknowledging what, how their things is, how the structure is also functioning, or what is that is deep rooted in them. Because you don't want to hurt any sentiments. I didn't want to, but I eventually did. Because I didn't know that it was an issue. So I'm just saying that in gradually solving the bigger problem and understanding how things are functioning, you cannot solve all those problems together. Now, there are a lot of them. But what you can only do is the best you can in that section. You know, so probably, you know, we will be able to build those sustainable communities one day. That's how, you know, we'll be able to build sustainable. Yeah.